Okay. This is Barafinda Sekibo Fred, the international Romwarimu, the national teacher. Since wars begin in the minds of men, it is in the minds of men that the defenses of peace must be constituted. Therefore, I, Barafinda Sekibo Fred, the peaceful politician, the peaceful founder of the peaceful political party, so-called RUDA, in Rwanda. RUDA in full is Rwanda Revolutionary United Democratic Advancers. Here there is a lesson. The important lesson in the world, to the world people. United Nations is peace support operations under the coverage of international laws due to the introduction of the League of Nations. Birth of the United Nations in this world was to protect peace, stability, law and order in human societies globally. The League of Nations, predecessor of the United Nations. The League of Nations was created in the aftermath of the First World War, WW1. In the words of the covenant, the League's purpose was to promote international cooperation and to achieve international peace and security. It provided singularly and successful. The League alignated the international powers who were defeated in the First World War, WW1, and even failed to hold together, all the togetherness of the victorious allies. Indeed, the United Nations never became a member. During the 1920s and 1930s, the former allies of the World War I, WW1, drifted apart and disarmed. While international powers outside the League took to dictatorship and rearmament, one of the League's last acts was to expel the Soviet Union for its attack on Finland in 1939. As the international scene took on more ominous directions, the League of Nations was powerless to prevent the world's descent into a second global war. Here I mean WW2. How the United Nations differed from the League of Nations this time? The United Nations, here I mean UN, or you know, was created in 1945 during the formation of Kigali City, the capital city of Rwanda. After WW2 or World War II, like the League of Nations, it was based on the assumption that the victorious wartime powers would keep the international peace, unlike the former League. However, the United Nations or UN made considerable efforts to reconcile and assimilate the defeated nations of the World War II, I mean WW2. In addition, the rapid growth of its membership due to decolonization gave new nations a voice and influence that they had never had before. That was the coming of UA, resurrecting the League of Nations, Loni. This is, you know, now is the ringleader in bringing, maintaining peacekeeping operations in the world. Therefore, as I have said above, that since wars begin in the minds of men, it is in the minds of men that the defenses of peace must be constituted. We need the world men and women. I mean here, ladies and gentlemen, law and order in the world is highly needed in our world people. The United Nations Charter and Peace Support Operations. The United Nations Charter, the UN Charter, was drafted at the San Francisco Conference in 1945. Its first article states that a main purpose of UN is to maintain international peace and security. The Charter provides the terms of reference for the various elements of the UN in fulfilling this responsibility. Chapter 6 of the UN Charter provides for the Pacific settlement of disputes or disputes by a virus or a variety of peaceful measures, including negotiation, inquiry, mediation, conciliation, abstraction, and judicial settlement. Article 33, Chapter 7, on the other hand, is essentially coercive in its designed to deal with threats to peace, breaches of the peace, and acts of aggression perpetrated by sovereign states. As outlined in the contents of Chapter 7, the UN Security Council is empowered to investigate alleged violations and then determine measures to be taken against the nations concerned. These measures can include provisional ones without prejudice to the rights, claims, or positions of the parties concerned. Article 40, political economic pressure. Article 41, the use of force. Article 42, coalition operations. For example, in Korea, against Iraq and in Somalia, where enforcement action is authorized by the UN Security Council. Peacekeeping. The Charter of UN doesn't specifically provide for peacekeeping and in fact makes no mention of the word peacekeeping, which requires the cooperation of the parties in a conflict. Evolved as pragmatic response to a variety of international conflicts that have been placed on the UN agenda over the years. In effort, peacekeeping as a United Nations operation has sought to settle disputes through the intervention of peaceful third party or initiatives. These include unarmed military observers as well as armed peacekeepers. Note, withstanding its limitations, peacekeeping has often proved to be a valuable technique to control and resolve and resolution of conflict in the world. To protect itself and carry out the mandate in very difficult circumstances, but it is well to keep in mind that in general the peacekeeping force is a lightly armed one, and in the wrong term or wrong run, giving a lightly armed peacekeeping force unrealistic objectives can be undermined or undermine its credibility and eventually destroy the nation. Therefore, peace enforcement must be put in action when necessary. Just in a few words, the world must be kept safe and sound in total security. Law and order must be respected. No human violations must be encouraged. No human violations must be encouraged or supported everywhere, wherever you are, wherever you lead, wherever you operate from, wherever you grow from, or wherever you have very many supporters or few supporters. Therefore, peace is the general concern of all societies in the world. This is Barafinda Sechibo Fred. Call me at +250 78 34 28 6 2, Kigali, Rwanda. The senior politician, Barafinda Sechibo Fred, the peaceful man, the man of 200 good men causes to stabilize and lead the state in harmony, in peace, stability, and in total security in every section of life. Here I mean stomach security, concerning food security, water security, education security, health security, and security services too. Transport security, on water, land, air, underground. So security is in every section of life, as I have mentioned above. Property security, the property of everyone must be having security. No one is allowed to destroy someone's property whatsoever. However big you are, however strong you are, however being supported at any maximum, respect of your peoples or your friends or other people's property must be respected as you demand the yours also to be respected. Thank you very much indeed. Protection in general is highly needed by everyone. It is my great pleasure to hope that you are going to keep on listening on this speech, which shall rebuild you once more again. Thank you indeed. More times.